I shall be talking to you about corrosive or acid injury of the food pipe and stomach. This is something which we see in quite often in our clinical practice when people try to consume either bathroom cleaning fluids like Harpic, toilet cleaners or acids available in the laboratory, either accidentally or by choice. Actually, this accidental ingestion is seen in infants and children who by mistakenly swallow this colorless fluids, taking it granted for water, and then sustain injury to their mouth, the food pipe and stomach. And also seen in youngsters who during exam times, especially when the exam results are announced, we've seen quite a lot of young girls consuming acid in an attempt to kill themselves. And the third category of people who also try consume this is the goldsmiths, who try to mix alcohol with the aqua regia, which is a mixture of sulfuric and nitric acid used in their trade, and that will cause severe burns to the food pipe and stomach. Some of them take just a little bit and spit it out because of the corrosive nature. Some others swallow, take a gulp, and that likely to cause more injury to the food pipe. Whenever they consume this, immediately they will vomit out, and some of them vomit blood, and a few others will develop what is called stridor, where they have difficulty in breathing because of the acute swelling of the throat. They are usually brought to the hospital and then a first aid is given. Couple of occasions the doctors try to bring out the fluid from within the stomach, and if possible try to do an endoscopy and look at the amount of injury that occurs to the food pipe or stomach. Actually, depending upon the concentration of the ingestant and whether it is an alkali or acid and the volume, the extent of injury takes place. Soon after their admission to the hospital, in about a day or two, they will sort of settle down and try to able to drink liquids, and that's when they get discharged. Some of these patients will be administered steroids to prevent inflammation of the food pipe. If the ingestion of this acid and alkali is too much, there are chances when the food pipe can totally get destroyed and also the stomach, and that will require emergency surgery, and but then that will eventually lead to some very disastrous consequence. But a majority of them, when they become all right at the end of 2 or 3 days, they go back home. They feel all right because they are able to swallow liquids, but at the end of about a month, they slowly develop dysphagia or inability to drink water or eat food, and that's when the problem starts. And then when they come back to the hospital, the doctors will try to assess the damage again to see how much is the food pipe involvement and the stomach. And this is done by two methods. One is by barium, where a white liquid is given and our patient is asked to swallow, and the x-ray is taken to see whether the food pipe is blocked, and if it is blocked in how many places, and whether the stomach is injured as well. Secondly, and that is the time when an endoscopy is done, and also to assess the sequelae of this acid injury and then attempt to dilate it. Many patients after ingestion of this acid and alkali develop problems that includes inability to eat, and then slowly they lose weight. And the physicians will try assess to see the extent of injury and then try dilate it. A good number of these patients can have a dilatation, that is by passing on some tubes through down the mouth, down the throat, the narrowing of the food pipe can be widened. And at the same time, an endoscopy is done to look into see the sequelae of this acid into the stomach. Some of these patients have a very tight stricture or very irregular strictures, and then they will not be able to eat food. And these are the patients which we generally put in a tube into the abdomen called a feeding jejunostomy for feeding purposes, and then we'll wait and watch. These patients in the next couple of months, they'll not be able to swallow even saliva, and you can see them spitting into, all of them will carry a small container for them to spit into. At the end of 6 months, generally, we again reassess the whole situation to see the extent of injury, whether the larynx, the voice box is involved, whether the extent of involvement of the food pipe as well as the stomach, and based on it, we have to devise on what surgery we have to undertake. If there is enough cervical esophagus or the available food pipe in the neck, it's possible, if the stomach is not injured, to take the stomach and put it into the neck to make a passage for food. But a good number of patients, we have to take the colon or the large intestine, which we have to connect to the small bowel and the neck, and this is called coloplasty. There are few other patients in which this procedure will be very difficult because the injury will be very severe and there is hardly any food pipe in the neck available. That's when we link the colon to the lateral pharyngeal wall. So subsequently, the rehabilitation will take some time, and over a period of time, the patients will be in a position to eat solid food. And the most important thing in these patients is that they need to have psychological counseling to find out what is the reason for their acid ingestion, and because the chances of these people trying to drink acid once again are very high. A proper psychological counseling will help these patients in the long run. So effectively, acid or alkali, a bathroom cleaner's ingestion is a common thing which we see in our clinical practice. It's seen in children and also adults, some by choice, some by chance, and they lead to disastrous consequences where patients lose a lot of weight. Subsequently, they have to be imaged with the help of bariums and endoscope. Some of them can be treated without surgery by dilatation, but a large number of them need very complex surgery which is undertaken in high volume centers. Thank you.
For more updates and videos, subscribe our YouTube channel, The Gastro Specialist.